Bonjour, année 9. Vous me manquez. I miss you all. J'espère que vous allez bien. Aujourd'hui, c'est lundi 27 avril et nous allons commencer avec la lecture et la musique. Qu'est-ce que c'est? La lecture. La musique, c'est facile, mais la lecture. La lecture means reading. It's where we get our word lecture from, because generally when somebody used to give a lecture, they would be reading from from notes. So obviously we're continuing our theme of free time activities. Alors, les opinions, qu'est-ce que c'est? Un peu de révision. J'adore. J'ai une passion pour. J'apprécie beaucoup. Je préfère. J'ai horreur de. Qu'est-ce que c'est? J'adore, obviously, I love. J'ai une passion pour. Literally, I have a passion for something. We'd probably translate it as I really love or I'm passionate about. J'apprécie beaucoup. I really like or I really appreciate something. Je préfère, that's straightforward. J'ai horreur de. We came across this, didn't we? Something you really dislike. Okay, I have a horror of. Can you add a noun to make a sentence? Remember that the French always use the definite article. J'ai une passion pour le cinéma. I'm passionate about the cinema. Okay. J'apprécie beaucoup la musique. Just take some time to write these little phrases down. Write a sentence for each one. Okay. All you have to do is add a noun onto the end. Just take a little time, pause the video or the PowerPoint, however you're looking at this, and write your sentences. Okay, we're going to do a little bit of listening now, but first of all, let's just check what we've got in front of us. We've got the opinions that we've already looked at. Then we've got different types of reading. Un roman is a novel or a book, a fiction book, so a made-up story. BD, bande dessinée, comic books like Tintin or Asterix, these are really big in France. They're a very important part of French culture. Les mangas, obviously Japanese-style comic books, you may have come across those. They are also really popular in France. And then at the end there, you've got livre d'épouvante. Épouvante means horror, so horror stories. Let's listen and see for each person, you're going to write what their opinion is and what type of book they are mentioning that they like or they don't like. Okay, so here we go. Let's just check my technological wizardry. Not. And see if I can make this work.
Unité 3. Lecture et musique. Page 36. Exercice 1. Écoutez. Pour chaque personne, écrivez la lettre de l'opinion et du genre de livre mentionné. 1.
Moi, j'apprécie beaucoup les livres d'épouvante. Moi, j'apprécie beaucoup les livres d'épouvante.
Okay, so I've given you the answer there. J'apprécie beaucoup. I really like, I really appreciate. And then this person mentioned les livres d'épouvante, horror stories. Have a listen now to the rest and I'll bring up the answers at the end. Bonne chance!
2.
J'adore les BD, moi. J'adore les illustrations. J'adore les BD, moi. J'adore les illustrations.
3.
Je n'aime pas les mangas. Pour moi, les mangas ne sont pas intéressants. Je n'aime pas les mangas. Pour moi, les mangas ne sont pas intéressants.
4.
J'ai une passion pour les romans d'amour. J'ai une passion pour les romans d'amour.
5.
Moi, je préfère les romans policiers. Ils sont passionnants. Moi, je préfère les romans policiers. Ils sont passionnants.
6.
J'ai horreur des romans fantastiques. Je trouve les romans fantastiques barbants. J'ai horreur des romans fantastiques. Je trouve les romans fantastiques barbants.
Okay, how did you get on? Let's have a look at those answers then. So number 2 was C, j'adore les BD. Number 3 was je n'aime pas les mangas. Number 4, j'ai une passion pour les romans d'amour. Number 5, je préfère les romans policiers. And number 6, j'ai horreur des romans fantastiques. So, along the bottom, the romans fantastiques, so fantasy novels, romans d'amour, love stories, romans policiers, obviously like detective stories, crime stories. We're going to listen to those again, see if you can get a little bit of extra detail on each one. I'll pause it after each one. I'd like you to write down what you think you hear. Okay, here we go.
Unité 3. Lecture et musique. Page 36. Exercice 1. Écoutez. Pour chaque personne, écrivez la lettre de l'opinion et du genre de livre mentionné. 1.
Moi, j'apprécie beaucoup les livres d'épouvante. Moi, j'apprécie beaucoup les livres d'épouvante.
Okay, first one, there were no extra details in that one. Let's carry on from number 2.
2.
J'adore les BD, moi. J'adore les illustrations. J'adore les BD, moi. J'adore les illustrations.
So this person says that they like comic books. They say, j'adore les illustrations. I love the illustrations. Did you get that? Let's listen to the next one.
3.
Je n'aime pas les mangas. Pour moi, les mangas ne sont pas intéressants. Je n'aime pas les mangas. Pour moi, les mangas ne sont pas intéressants.
So this person doesn't like mangas. They say, pour moi, les mangas ne sont pas intéressantes. Pour moi, les mangas ne sont pas intéressantes. For me, they are not interesting.
4.
J'ai une passion pour les romans d'amour. J'ai une passion pour les romans d'amour.
So no extra detail there.
5.
Moi, je préfère les romans policiers. Ils sont passionnants. Moi, je préfère les romans policiers. Ils sont passionnants.
So what adjective did they use there to describe detective novels? Did you hear it? Passionnant. Exciting. Okay, not passionate. It means exciting. Passionnant.
6.
J'ai horreur des romans fantastiques. Je trouve les romans fantastiques barbants. J'ai horreur des romans fantastiques. Je trouve les romans fantastiques barbants.
Okay, nice little phrase to finish off with. Je trouve les romans fantastiques barbants. Je trouve, I find, and then barbant. Great description to, great way to describe something that's boring, annoying, gets on your nerves. So barbant. Remember we talked about growing a beard. Ça me donne de la barbe. It gives me a beard. That's how the French describe something that annoys them. Anyway, hope you got on okay with that. Let's move on. So we've got some reading here. Lisez ces textes. Copiez, complétez les phrases en anglais. Reading comprehension here. take your time. I'm going to read through each text and you can read along with me. And then take your time to fill out the blanks. It's helping you understand the individual text. So, Léopold. Je lis beaucoup de BD parce que j'aime les illustrations. Par contre, je n'aime pas les romans d'amour. Je trouve ça barbant. Je ne lis pas sur une tablette, car je préfère tenir un livre traditionnel dans mes mains. J'aime tourner les pages une à une. Myriam, moi j'adore la lecture, j'apprécie beaucoup les romans policiers et je suis fan des romans fantastiques. En ce moment, je lis La quête de Ewilan, c'est super. Mais je ne lis plus de livres traditionnels. Je préfère lire sur ma tablette parce que c'est pratique et écologique. Soraya, je ne lis jamais de livres, mais je lis beaucoup en ligne. Je lis des blogs, des tweets, le journal, etc. Sur Internet, il est possible de trouver toutes sortes d'informations et je trouve ça génial. Okay, some interesting vocab in there. Take a bit of time, read them yourself again, pause the video or the PowerPoint here, and just have a go at filling in the blanks. Okay, I'm going to give you the answers now. So, Léopold doesn't like romance novels. He finds them boring, barbant. Okay, that was that word that we had earlier. He doesn't read on a tablet because he prefers holding a traditional book in his hands. Je préfère tenir un livre traditionnel dans mes mains. Okay, I prefer to hold a traditional book in my hands. He also goes on to say he likes to turn the pages. Let's have a look at Myriam. Myriam likes detective novels, les romans policiers, and fantasy novels. She no longer reads traditional books. She prefers to read on her tablet. Why is that? Practical, pratique et écologique. Soraya never reads books, but she reads a lot en ligne, online. Okay, so different vocab there. What are you going to do with those new words? Make a little box somewhere on your sheet of paper, maybe to highlight new words that you're writing down. Things like en ligne, if you didn't remember that, or barbant for boring, tenir, meaning to hold. So have a look and see how you can organize your new vocabulary. Right, we've done a little bit about negatives already. We know that negatives come in two parts, which go around the French verb. So ne or pas means not. Je ne lis pas beaucoup, I don't read a lot. Ne jamais, we've come across that, never. She never reads, elle ne lit jamais. Here's a one that we may not have come across, je ne lis plus. I no longer, or I don't read anymore. Okay, ne plus means no longer. I'd like you to copy this grammar section out. It's really useful. If the negative is followed by a noun, you usually put de afterwards. Je ne lis pas de roman. Je ne lis jamais de manga. But if you're using aimer, I don't like something, then you still use the article. So je n'aime pas les livres d'épouvante. I don't like horror novels. So copy that out for me and then have a go at translating the sentences underneath. If you're able to access the student book using your Active Learn login, you can read more about negatives on page 206. That was the login which I gave you on the last Show My Homework. So pause the video or the PowerPoint here and just have a go at copying out that grammar and doing those translations. So, how did we get on? Traduction. I don't read comic books. So first of all, you're thinking about where's my verb in here? The verb is to read. So you're thinking about how would I say I read, je lis. And then we have to put our negative around that verb. Je ne lis pas. Je ne lis pas de BD. Okay, I don't know what's happened to my numbering here. Number one again. I never read horror novels. So again, we're looking for our verb first of all, which would be I read. And then we're putting our negative around it. Now remember to say never, we put ne and jamais around the verb. Je ne lis jamais de livres d'épouvante. Changing the verb here. So he no longer reads romance novels. Let's think about how we would say he reads. Okay, so we're looking for our pronoun, he. That's going to be il. We've had a look at how verbs change a little bit. You can see with each pronoun, you've got a different form of the verb. So instead of lis, it's going to be lit for il lit. And then we're going to put our negative around that. Il ne lit plus de romans d'amour. He no longer reads romance novels. And then we don't like mangas. Now remember, the French always include the article. So we don't like the mangas. Okay, so we're looking for our pronoun. We can use on or we can use nous. And remember, we have to change the verb accordingly depending on which person we're talking about, and then we put our negative around it. On n'aime pas, or nous n'aimons pas les mangas. If you want to read a bit more about negatives, as I said, and if you can access the student book, you can have a look on page 206. So we're going to do some listening here. What I'd like you to do is jot down, you just need five columns. Type of music the person likes, type of music they don't like, how they listen to their music, their favourite singer, and a reason. Okay, so just take your time to jot those headings down. It doesn't have to be neat, it's just interested in your listening abilities here. So you've got the various sections that the answers will be coming from. Let's do the first one together. Okay.
Exercice 5. Écoutez. Copiez et complétez le tableau en anglais. 1.
Quelle musique aimes-tu, Laura?
J'ai une passion pour la musique pop. Je trouve ça génial.
Quelle musique n'aimes-tu pas?
Je n'aime pas du tout la musique classique. Je n'écoute jamais ça.
Okay, so the first two questions, what music do you like? Obviously, she mentioned pop music. And what doesn't she like? She doesn't like classical music. Okay, she says she never listens to that. Je n'écoute jamais. Okay, now she's going to be asked, how do you listen to your music? So let's see what she says.
Comment écoutes-tu ta musique?
Normalement, j'écoute ma musique sur mon ordi, chez moi, dans ma chambre.
Okay, so there she's quite straightforward, isn't it? She's saying she listens to it on her computer. She gives an extra little detail. See if you can get that next time. And then we're going to hear her talking about her favourite singer, why and who her favourite singer is and why.
Qui est ton chanteur ou ta chanteuse préférée et pourquoi?
Ma chanteuse préférée, c'est Taylor Swift, car j'aime ses paroles.
Okay, so she says her favourite singer, did you get that? It was Taylor Swift. She says, j'aime ses paroles, I like the words. So you've got different, let's just have a quick look at the vocab that we've got there. Types of music, straightforward, I think. Le reggae, le jazz, le rap, le rock, la musique pop, la musique classique. How does she listen? The first one, sur mon téléphone portable, avec mes écouteurs. So on my phone, with my earphones. Then the one that we've just heard on my computer, mon ordi, it's short for ordinateur. And then the third one along, je regarde des clips vidéo, so watching video clips, or j'écoute sur une tablette, I listen on a tablet. So the reasons why they might like somebody, j'aime ses paroles, I like her words, sa musique me donne envie de danser, their music makes me want to dance, j'aime ses mélodies, I like the tunes, sa musique me donne envie de chanter, their music makes me want to sing. Okay, let's listen to the rest and see how we get on.
2.
Quelle musique aimes-tu, Mathieu?
J'apprécie beaucoup le rap.
Quelle musique n'aimes-tu pas?
Je n'écoute jamais de jazz. Ce n'est pas pour moi.
Et comment écoutes-tu ta musique?
D'habitude, pour écouter ma musique, je regarde des clips vidéo. C'est cool.
Qui est ton chanteur ou ta chanteuse préférée et pourquoi?
Mon chanteur préféré, c'est Julien Doré, car j'aime ses paroles et ses mélodies.
3.
Quelle musique aimes-tu, Céline?
Moi, j'ai une passion pour le reggae. J'adore.
Et quelle musique n'aimes-tu pas?
Je n'aime pas le rock. Mon père est fan de rock, mais je trouve ça barbant.
Comment écoutes-tu ta musique?
Normalement, j'écoute ma musique sur mon téléphone portable avec mes écouteurs. J'écoute de la musique vraiment partout.
Qui est ton chanteur ou ta chanteuse préférée et pourquoi?
Mon chanteur préféré, c'est Bob Marley, car j'aime ses mélodies et sa musique me donne envie de danser.
4.
Quelle musique aimes-tu, Sébastien?
Moi, j'ai une passion pour la musique classique. Je joue aussi du piano.
Quelle musique n'aimes-tu pas?
Je n'aime pas le rap. C'est ennuyeux, voilà.
Comment écoutes-tu ta musique?
En général, j'écoute ma musique sur une tablette. C'est vraiment pratique.
Qui est ton chanteur ou ta chanteuse préférée et pourquoi?
Ma chanteuse préférée, c'est Adèle, car j'aime ses paroles et sa musique me donne envie de chanter.
So there we go. Remember, you can go back and listen to it again. If you're watching this on the YouTube clip, you can just obviously repeat it. If you're listening to it on the PowerPoint, you'll need to click back at the beginning of the slide again. It's a little bit harder on the PowerPoint. But take your time, listen to it as many times as you like, and then I'm going to bring up the answers on the next page. So the first one we did together, didn't we? They like pop music, didn't like classical, listen on her computer. The extra bit of detail was at home in her room, dans ma chambre, chez moi, dans ma chambre. Favorite singer, Taylor Swift, she likes the lyrics. Okay, j'aime les paroles. Okay, number two, they like rap, they don't like jazz, they watch music videos. Favorite singer is Julien Doré, French singer. He likes the lyrics and the tunes, les paroles et les mélodies. This person likes reggae, they don't like rock. She listens to it on her phone and with earphones or headphones. Everywhere, the little word that she used for everywhere was partout, p-a-r-t-o-u-t, a useful word, partout, everywhere. Her favorite singer is Bob Marley. She likes his tunes and the music makes her want to dance. Number four, they like classical music. They don't like rap. They listen to it on a tablet. Favorite singer is Adele. They like the lyrics and the music makes him want to sing. Okay, hope you got those details there. Let's go on to our next activity. Can you rope in someone from home to ask you these questions, or maybe do it with a friend over the phone, use the phrases that you heard in the listening exercise to help you. You can just move it back just to have a look at those different answers. Quelle musique aimes-tu? Quelle musique n'aimes-tu pas? Comment écoutes-tu ta musique? Qui est ton chanteur, ta chanteuse préférée? Have a think about those answers. How might you answer those questions? Write the questions down. Have a think about your answer. Write your answer down. And then get somebody from home to ask you those questions. See if you can remember what you've written. See if you can do your answers without reading them. So have a go. A little challenge for you. A little bit of speaking. Bonne chance. Hope it goes well. Right, we're going to do a little bit of translation now. All right, so we've got a text in French. And we're going to work our way through it. So you've got some helpers here where it gives you some little tips. So j'ai une passion pour la musique. It says try to think about what would sound best in English. We wouldn't say I have a passion for. We might instead say I'm passionate about or I really love. I think it's probably best to try and stick to as close as you can. So I am passionate about would be a good translation there. The next little purple box, on, we're going to translate that as we here. Sometimes, you know, it can be translated as you, but in this context, we're going to use we. On joue ensemble depuis 2 ans. Do you remember the formation of the present tense and depuis? So we play together since 2 years, but we wouldn't translate it like that, would we? How would we translate it in English? J'aime aussi créer des playlists avec mes copains. On partage les playlists sur les réseaux sociaux. Ma musique préférée, c'est le rock, évidemment. Mais j'apprécie aussi le rap et le reggae. Okay, just pause the video here. Have a little think about how you might translate that. There's some really good phrases. I'd really like you to copy this out because you can adapt this in your own writing. So if you copy out the translation in French and then write your English translation underneath. I'm going to just pause it here because I'm going to bring up the answer in just a second. So I'm passionate about music and I play the guitar or I play guitar in a rock group. We have been playing together for 2 years. Remember, we don't say we play together since 2 years. We have been playing together for 2 years. I also like creating or to create playlists. So the French have got the infinitive here, créer, to create. So you can translate it either as creating or to create with my friends. On partage, we share playlists. Les réseaux sociaux, social networks. My favorite music is rock, obviously, évidemment, nice little word there. But I also like rap and reggae. Okay, I wonder how you found that. I hope it wasn't too difficult. We're going to do our own little piece of writing now. So, we are going to do a piece of writing now. Quelle musique écoutes-tu? Write 50 to 60 words about what music you listen to, who your favourite singer is and why. Use the vocab from the listening exercise to help you. So also have a think about those questions that you wrote answers to when you were doing the speaking. So you could use those to make the sort of format of your piece of writing. Could you add in a negative? I never listen to jazz. Obviously not true for me. Je n'écoute jamais de jazz. Okay. Have a go doing a piece of writing. When you're finished, you can take a photograph of it and send it to me on Show My Homework. If you can access your school email, you can email me. And if you've done a Word document, you can send it as an attachment. If you don't have your school email, get Mum or Dad or somebody at home to email me on the work email. That would be fine too. Bonne chance avec ça. I hope you get on well with that. And I look forward to seeing how you get on. I'm going to put a little extension on the next slide if you would like a little bit of extra work. Okay, so this is the active learn. Anyway, I'm looking forward to seeing how you get on. Take care, everybody, and keep well. Bonne continuation et bonne santé. À bientôt. So we're going to move on now to the extension. Active Learn. Once you've worked your way through the PowerPoint, if you would like some extra work, log on to Active Learn and have a go at the tasks I have set there. It is really, really good consolidation. Remember, I told you in a previous homework that was entitled Experiment, what your username was. And some of you I know have had a go at it already, so keep going. And your username was your name with no spaces but capitals for first and second names. The password was pitville2020. Some of you, Sam, Will and Tyler, you had an extra 9 at the end of your name, so it would have been Sam Crumpler 9. Send me a message if you can't get on. Au revoir tout le monde et à bientôt.